Yeah, they did eventually kind of run into that wall, I feel like, and Rival did a great job sort of exacerbating that weakness to their roster. But Retribution, they don't have a ton of time to make an adaptation here to try and get back and figure out what it is going to work up against this Rival squad, because this is it. Game 2 now backs up against the wall. Rival could put them down right here, right now, or maybe Retribution can force their way into a Game 3. I'm very curious if they want to try and force that Double Hunter again. But looks like so far, same old, same old. They're going to ban him with the Turnabog, and I imagine the Freya like we saw in Game 1. No, Sir Cat, I like it.
Ooh, okay. I think that this is a little bit interesting, though, that they felt as though Rapio was that much of a problem with the Sir Cat. If anything, I didn't really... I mean, don't get me wrong. I think that Rapio certainly played a part in that Game 1 victory, but
right.
It didn't feel like the Sir Cat was that threatening in terms of space control. Early on, Rapio was shut out of his own jungle, pretty much, and I just think that it's really interesting that Retribution feel that threatened by it that they wouldn't opt to ban away something like the Baron, where it felt like Predators was giving them infinitely more problems.
And it didn't seem as if they had very many answers to it either, right, on their checklist. They were able to keep Rapio in check somewhat, but not the Baron. So that's sort of what I was thinking, right? Maybe you ban that and then you can try and deal with the Sir Cat one more time, but not going to be the plan here. As Retribution, they want that Ratatosker for USB one more time. And Rival are going to respond. That's the dual lane, by the way. No confusion there for me on where that stuff's going. That's Dinosaur and Coast going. Try and invade us now.
You don't think Fly can play
I know
dual
he can.
Lane in the mid lane?
I know he can. I know that he won't.
I mean, to be fair, I don't think anybody on his team wants to see him play Uller in the mid lane. When you have Vaporish Coast on your team, it just makes sense. The kid is practically Uller now.
Yeah, at this point, he really has kind of built himself up a name on this pick. But this is interesting. Rival banned away Thanatos in their first bans last time when they didn't have to ban away the Freya. So that means they were worried about this Thanatos coming out. Now we have questions. Where is this stuff going, right? Ratatosk, Thanatos, and Geb all here. Are there enough positions for everyone? Someone's got to go solo.
Here's my problem with Retribution's draft so far, because I kind of see where they're going with this in terms of they just want the hard execute comp. You've got the Ratatosker to kind of get things going with the initiation.
Wow.
I'd imagine that to be the solo lane Ratatosker also, not a solo lane Thanatos. But it's just for early pressure, early abuse against Predators, looking to maybe bully him out of that lane, which could then in turn end up bullying Rapio out of the jungle if you're able to get off strong invades with the Thanatos-Ratatosker combination. However, we can definitely see a repeat happening here from Game 1.
Yes.
If Retribution, the main thing that they didn't do in Game 1 was pressure their lead.
They're doubling down on it.
And now they're going all in with this.
They really are. But it's hard for me to think of more... And how the Raijin come out. It's hard for me to think of more signature picks for all four of them than this. Fly on the Raijin, Predators on the Hercules, Coast on this Uller pick. Rival want this to... They want to shut this down. And that's what it feels like with these picks here for me. They're picking, I feel like, some of their best gods, their signature picks. And I'm a little worried for Retribution. 12,
21, and they're
I like the mage, though. I like that.
They're going all in right now. Poseidon, that's going to be the big burst damage that we were asking for, but... concerns about that Shivalanke, because if there's one thing that Lizer didn't have to worry about last match was any form of pressure. This time around, Rival have the pressure. Raijin, Raven, that is a mid-jungle composition that can certainly go toe-to-toe with the Rata and Thanatos. And Poseidon might even encounter some difficulties there with the Whirlpool facing off against the Percussive Storm early on.
Who do you think is going to win this game? I'm going with the team that I think literally got their number one off their draft boards for everything.
Thanks for casting this. We can't.
Oh, I can't give my picks?
We got
their number one off their draft boards for every one of them. Rapio and Robin, are you kidding me? I'm just saying, it's a scary draft. I don't know. I don't know what's going to... I literally don't know what's going to happen.
Logically speaking,
but I'm leaning
every part of my brain is telling me, yeah, Rival are looking pretty good to take this one home, but you never know. Retribution might just be looking for a little bit of their own redemption.
And they've got the kind of draft that can get it done, right? If USB can get a couple early kills on Thanatos and get that ball rolling, it's one of the hardest balls to stop. It's just going to keep going out of control. He does so much damage. But the question is, can he get that ball rolling, right?
We'll have to wait and see. But respect to Dobson, rocking that London Conspiracy Poseidon skin. Haven't seen that one in quite some time.
All right, then.
Bit of a throwback.
That is indeed. Who is that? That was like old, like Emilzy and I don't know.
Yeah,
that was
the original. I think that was the first org that Emilzy ever actually played main roster for. Because before that, he was like a coach, I believe, for Coast.
Yeah, I don't even remember who I was on, but that's the old one. But yeah, rocking it here is Dobbs in the mid lane. This time, he will indeed be on the mage, and there is plenty of setup for him. And yeah, I'm with you, chat. Recognition, I think that that Rival have a good draft here, but there's plenty of setup, I feel like, for this Poseidon this game.
You know what, though? That 8%, those are the real ones for Retribution. Yeah, those really are the ride or dies. Like, we are going all the way home for you guys tonight.
There's no truer than that 8. No, there's no Rival with
these picks.
It's like
the two guys that like your Twitter. The only two people, like, the same, when you see the same two people that favorite all your same tweets and everything.
Like, you put it out 15 seconds later, your boy's right there liking it, right?
Yes.
Hitting that retweet. You know who it is. Yeah. But, I mean, like, what I'm saying is I don't think Retribution could be more up with their backs against the wall than against a team like Rival with a draft like this. These are, I think, all of their best picks right now they've been able to grab. So those 8%, man, they're with Retribution all the way.
And to be fair to Retribution as well, I think I would rather see a team look to do something a little bit more unconventional and janky if it means maybe getting an upper hand against Rival, because Rival have been the undisputed number one team in Europe for quite some time now, and
all of
only
five, yeah.
Just recently have teams really started giving them a run for their money in Europe, and not making it so we just automatically assume they're going to be the representatives from EU.
It is kind of tough to pick Shibalanka into Uller, though, right? Uller is so much early pressure, and Shibalanka is so little of it. I mean,
but he's got the Geb.
He does have the Geb there. Oh, you're right. Yeah, who also has no early pressure. Good point. No chance, right, of that happening. But if they make it late, Geb Shibalanka is a sick team to have, right?
That was actually a nice play out of Total Bad Boy. He got the Shockwave off to prevent Vaporish Ghost from getting the stance switch immediately,
right?
So he couldn't get the bladed arrow off right away. So,
but it does seem a bit different, doesn't it? Geb Shibalanka is not going to be doing much for your early game, but I'm thinking Rattatas for Thanatos. That's purely early game. Are they just trying to get this dual lane to the late game, or? Because I don't think it's on two separate pages. It feels like they want to try and pass the baton.
The problem is Thanatos tends to thrive in an environment where people just don't want to contest the Thanatos, because it's like, oh my god, you're a Thanatos. I don't want to come near you because your Scythe does a billion damage to me at level 3.
Right.
But in this position, speaking of which, Dobson in a whole world of trouble here. Rapio's going to end up finding the first blood. I believe that was just a regular in hand also. Just follow up from that percussive storm.
Yeah, overpowered USB just wasn't there, and unfortunately Dobson gets caught out, and they get first blood over to Rapio on Robin, who knows how to play this god in the early game. Red buff invade going to come out as a result now. The rest of Rivals swarm onto it. They're going to look for the purple buff as well. To be honest, this might be a little bit par for the course of the dual lane they drafted, but losing the red buff too definitely hurts.
And going back to what I was saying though, Finch, actually hold that thought, because Lizer now getting body blocked thanks to the perfect placement out of Dinosaur. Shell has already been forced in Total Bad Boy looking for the getaway.
He is able to dash away from that axe, but Dinosaur takes so little damage, he can keep standing at the front and blocking some of these auto attacks and trading out up against Lizer and Total Bad Boy. Root gonna come through. Dinosaur is now out of mana. Good shockwave from Bad Boy and a good shield coming out. Bad Boy doing everything he can to keep Lizer on this earth, and now Dobson and USB are on their way.
Might have just bought them just enough time. Total Bad Boy looking for the slow onto Dinosaur, and it does connect. Lizer now with the extended damage out of that Rising Jaguar, but Total Bad Boy with the Blink Shockwave is just too far away from Dinosaur.
Vaporous Coast wants to go back in and try and make the trade happen. Unfortunately, the Geb Shield is there, so he's not going to be able to find it. Dinosaur has got to watch his teammate fall to the hungry wolves that came in looking for a snack.
Just a little bit too little of mana there for Vaporish. Had he had any, he would have been fine. Speaking of which, though, Predators
solo
driving strike into Meownate. A rather interesting moment there for Predators. I kind of watched it happen in front of my eyes, but it took me a second to process that he really chose the driving strike forward with 30%.
Yeah, he had the pressure early on in that lane, but it looks like the health trade wasn't going in his favor anymore, and he ended up still trying to play it like he still had it, and Meownate just cleaned it up. That was as clean as you like. Root not going to land from Rapio, but he did get some good damage onto USB. The Whirlpool comes over the wall. Dobbs will be their support, but Rapio with the overhead kick trades favorably. Mystic Rush gets juked out. Rapio off the mark, and now he might end up falling to Meownate, who rotates over through the cosmos. They've got Dobbs in here as well. Rapio will fall. Total Bad Boy grabs the kill.
A little bit too much of an investment there,
yes,
from Rapio. Now Fly could be in danger, but instead, Overpowered USB is not going to choose to use that Hovering Death onto Fly. Will back off to his speed buff instead. I'm just surprised that Rapio invested the Mystic Rush Because even if he succeeds in landing that, the likelihood of him killing Overpowered without dying himself was just so low.
This is what's curious, though. Rival are overcommitting into the early game comp right here. Right? Cataclysm not going to land for Total Bad Boy, but the slow is going to come out from Meow Nade. USB just needs one more auto, it feels like. Driving Strike repositions, but right into the Shockwave Predators will fall. But Taco, this is the kind of stuff Retribution wants. They're not forcing the issue. Rival are.
No, this is Retribution doing a great job capitalizing off of Rival's mistakes, and they've managed to build themselves in a slight experience advantage. No, in fact, they are behind, in every way possible.
That's crazy, despite all these kills so far. That's just how good Rival are doing at farming here right now, apparently, at this point, it's still going in their favor.
Or that's how poorly Retribution are doing at farming, because with them finding the picks, they should be the ones also confirming the farm.
But they've been too busy focusing on these picks and maybe not farming efficiently as Dobson gets caught out again and overhead kick to immune the Kraken. That's why Poseidon is such a bad or has such a hard time into Robin. I feel like he has so many tools to get away.
Speaking of which, Vaporish now looking to take up a little slight little 1v1 there with Lizer, but did miss the axe initially. Well, maybe looking for it again. He jumps right in onto Overpowered USB, but Sight didn't connect. Beautiful bladed arrow onto two is going to spell disaster for Lizer and Overpowered USB. Overpowered just slinking away with his tail between his legs after that one.
Yeah, you can't line up because Vapor is going to hit every one of those, man. Able to find the bladed arrow. That sets up the nice kill. Now USB gets caught in the jungle. Rapio puts one in his back and takes the kill. They're evened up now 4-4. And this game swinging right back in favor of Rival.
Which is kind of crazy to say, because Rival were the ones getting picked, and yet they've been ahead the whole time,
That's
Finch.
True, you're
It's the ultimate bamboozling, and it's not ending anytime soon. Predator's even going all out with that excavate for the big harpy. Meowne not allowed even the slightest bit of farm here, as Predators looks to once again try and steal this blue buff.
And this is why I pointed out that these are comfort picks from Rival, because a couple early spills with these picks are not going to deter their aggression by any means. They feel like they're better than anyone else on these gods. And I think they might be right, by the way. I think that they have a good case to make there.
We can all make fun of Predators, though, for dashing in with,
yes,
with
did
the 30%
get
driving strike. He'll probably be hearing it from his own team, in fact. But right now, Rival Fly looking to help save the life of Dinosaur. Overpowered USB slightly off the mark there with that hovering death, I believe, and no real follow-up. And again, this has been the same problem for Retribution with that lack of follow-up.
They do at least force out two ultimates for just the one used by USB, but you're right. They didn't seem to be on the same page. And so far, in both games, I don't think Retribution's greatest strength is starting these fights off on the right foot. They've looked best when they're either responding to Rival or when there's not really a fight and they just successfully get their invades, at least so far. But so far as getting the fights off the right way, Rapio, please don't do it to him. The shield comes through to save him. Scythe off the mark. Rapio very nearly finds the kill.
This is temporary because Rapio's just going to blink right past the shockwave. He knew that was coming. Immediately into a Piranha Onslaught. That could not have been better play by Rapia.
Excuse me for thinking for some reason that USB
has made
that.
All of us, Finch. Don't. It's the caster's curse. Speaking of which, look at that damage out of the bladed arrow alone. Vaporish only needs a couple more in-hands to seal the deal, but not going to be able to find it. And the hail of arrows just out of range, but Vaporish still cutting downwards. Hoping that he can find Lizer.
That might not be far enough, man. Okay, Coast not going to come from it, so that is going to be enough for Lizer to make it right on out of there. Dobson making the rotation over. He is going to end up catching up with Dinosaur, but a good whirlpool to interrupt the dash. He'll just defend this tower.
Dobson just wants the farm, I think. He just ticked in at level 8. Rather far behind Vaporish, so probably doesn't want to look to stick around. But speaking of being behind, Lizer, a steep horror. He's actually level 6. It's 3 levels down.
Lowest in the game.
Rapio won't even let Overpowered leave his base.
Dinosaur will drop the Earth and Fury onto 2. Axe land. Hailed Blade of Arrows is right there to bring Total Bad Boy. Quite low, but not enough for any kind of kill. Vaporous Ghost and Dinosaur, though, continuing their bullying ways here in the dual lane. And Rapio is wrapping around onto Dobson. Could be trouble, but they do have USB right there to follow up.
I like the
In fact, he's going to end up falling. USB will drop to Fly.
Overhead kick, just a quick and easy one for that finish. And I think Dobson's just been having way too many problems with trying to find the timing to use that Kraken. You have to force out the overhead kick first from Rapio, but the problem is he's able to hold it the entire time.
There's nothing else to force out the overhead kick is really the problem, right? He's just going to save it for the Kraken from Dobson. It's a tough kick into this Robin. And now Lizer really with nowhere to go, being chased down by Predators, who just decided he didn't really want that kill anymore. Gold Fury being leased for now while Rat's in the air. They're going to let Meownate fall and give up on the Gold Fury. That is a small win for Retribution.
Well, they knew Meownate was there. Rapio again off the root with that blink over the wall there. Dobson probably happy about that one, but Total Bad Boy will end up getting scooped away into his own ultimate, forced out of that Cataclysm. Now Predator still trying to find the excavate for the finish. Total Bad Boy gonna just barely manage to sneak away from that one.
Boulder off the mark, but USB counters with his own off the mark site, so neither one of them really end up trading that much. Rival now looking to aggress again. The wall will not be off the mark. Root doesn't land. Beads gets Dobson out of there, and now the Thanatos has to run away. Rival, 5,000 gold out in the lead, or very nearly, appear to be in full control.
I don't think we've seen a single moment, though, of Overpowered using that hovering death aggressively.
No.
It has been almost exclusively held as an escape method for himself, and it's just impossible for him to find any side lane to gank because they didn't pick winning side lanes, and the one solo kill that happened for Retribution was Predator's overextending himself and pretty much alley-ooping the kill to Meownate, saying, hey man, I know how this one's gonna go, so I'll make you look like a god early on.
Just spot you one real quick here, apparently, was the idea from Predators. His Gold Fury will now be completed by Team Rival. They've got a deep ward showing them where Dobson is as well, so they should be free to keep going for this at this point. They're gonna fall back, but you bring up a good point that they didn't really pick any winning side lanes, did they? So where was USB supposed to go with this Thanatos? He would have an option because there's a good chance Rival would be pushed up to come gank, but it hasn't worked here. As Vaporous Coast taking the trade into the Darkest of Nights is going to have to think differently of it. In fact, Lizer is going to come in for the solo, but Rapio says there are no solos, sir, and Vaporous Coast makes it out.
That's one of those kills that happens, and Vaporous just has to clench the whole time. And now he's still looking to try and outrun Total Bad Boy and Overpowered USB.
What?
Beautiful save from Dinozo, but it's only a temporary relief. Overpower going to end up collecting a double kill now off of Fly, but Rapio with the cleanup.
Dobson comes in, finds one more kill, 3-for-2 so far, and getting a little bit ahead of himself. Total Bad Boy went to Rapio as well, but not that easy. A takedown of Robin, blink in, gives him the hands, and finds one more kill to even things out.
Yeah, to fix that face.
That's right.
But what a punish from Retribution. And the first real sign of life, I think, from the team.
Yes.
And taking down the carries that really needed to be handled. Fly and Vaporous, respectively. Those are huge bounty kills to collect. Lizer nearly had Vaporous dead by his own rights. And it had it not been for Rapio coming in as savior for Vaporous, that was a solo kill.
Absolutely, it would have been. Lizer stepping up there up against Vaporous Coast. Now, Vaporous was playing that one a little looser, I think.
Sometimes
than
you tank
would.
The wave
yeah.
entirely and the auto attacks from the enemy hunter. And
he wasn't even dodging anymore, yeah.
Well, it's because he's 3 levels down, so that's Vaporous being a little bit overconfident.
Yes.
I don't think we see him continuing to make that same notion after realizing there's still a chance for Lizer to combat him.
Yeah, I think I get where you're coming from there, right? Sometimes, especially someone like Vaporous Coast, who has a lot of confidence, and I think it's well-earned, he might overstep occasionally. But you accept those small oversteps because of how often my man is just getting it done for your team.
He might have been flexing for the timeline.
A little bit, yeah.
Right there. That's high.
A little bit.
Red buff.
He's trying to rectify that right here, though, Taco. Trying to catch Lizer in the jungle. Not going to land the axe, but will strip away the red buff.
Convenient for a rival that Vaporous is able to collect the red buff of Retribution because
level
that 14. Means that Fly can have Rival's red buff now if that's how they choose to spread things. But Pyromancer seems to be the next point of interest here for Rival. With Gold Fury having already been taken off the map, they may as well go for the next global objective. And this is what we wanted to see out of Retribution last time around when they had early game pressure. And it's what we're getting from Rival. And again, that's just mostly experience.
This is the most classic Predators thing I've ever seen. In between 4 members, back up to full health, finds the kill on the Total Bad Boy, and the Pyromancer goes down in Rival's favor. USB off the mark with the hovering death, and so he will join the land of the dead. That's a double kill for Predators. Rival continuing to surge. They might just go for the Fire Giant.
Good intentions don't always mean good decisions, and that was definitely the case there for Overpowered. Thought that maybe if he got the stun off onto Predators, the Scythe follow-up damage could be enough to take down this Hercules, but instead, With two members being dead and Dobson having expended that Kraken, there's no form of contest there for Retribution on this Fire Giant.
Almost in time was Meowne, but just a little bit too late. He gets pulled back in by the taunt there. Dinosaur considering backing, and I guess he was correct. His team just had that kill. Fly finishes it off. Rival now up 8,000 gold and 10,000 experience, only 15 minutes into the match.
And Predator seems to have caught the warm-up, by the way, because these Earthbreakers have all been connecting onto Retribution and wrecking havoc for their setup capabilities.
Yeah, at this point, it's just been a little bit too strong for them. Meowne, really nothing he could do. He was willing to trade his life there for a chance at the Fire Giant Steel, but really only a hair too late. He really almost had a shot at it, but just didn't arrive in time. But this game has been all Rival. Taco, it feels like from minute one, even when Retribution were finding some picks, it was just because Rival were overstepping a little bit too far or just being slightly careless. Now that they've kind of tightened it up, they appear to be in full control.
I think the best way to put it in perspective, Finch, is Rabio is so comfortable with where Rival are currently at that he's building a fourth item Transcendence.
That's pretty late, isn't it?
That's pretty fried, my guy, and incredibly late, but Rabio can do it because who's going to challenge him? He's three levels above overpowered USB, so this is Rabio saying, sure, man, why not?
That was through a Geb shield, by the way. USB will land the Scythe and heal right back up to half HP, but can we say the same for poor Meownate, who is going to try and make it up to the tree? He will indeed. They didn't have quite enough burst, but he will have to run away just to barely get away, but Rabio doesn't want to let him. He doesn't have Blink, but he does have Mystic Rush. The root doesn't land. And Meownate lives.
Creeps gave it away. If it wasn't for the creep wave, I don't think that Meownate sees that one coming.
And he would have unfortunately fallen. Predators once again is the only one here up against three members of the opposition while his team grabs the tier 2 tower in right. And they're just going to come right on over to grab the tier 2 in mid as well.
I got to say, despite how pressured out Retribution have been this entire match, I'm impressed with what Total Bad Boy was able to put out. This Geb gameplay has actually been incredibly strong, given that his team is playing from the back heel the entire time, but he's had a lot of really good cataclysms, a lot of strong shockwaves that interrupted, and plenty of shields that have saved the life of his teammates on more than one occasion.
I think Lizer is 0-4-1 if without Total Bad Boy, the way he's played this game. As Lizer now is able to Rising Jaguar away. Dinosaur unfortunately gets stunned, but Vaporage Coast undeterred. A good Geb shield and the Aegis comes through. Kraken not going to land on the Rapio, who finds Lizer. Total Bad Boy and Dobson both very low as well. As Predators get to USB, he will settle for the lone Geb and find himself a double. He does not have Mystic Rush or Blink, so Dobson should be out.
And that moment right there could not have been more perfect because it showed Total Bad Boy did everything right. Could have possibly done there. It's just that his team is simply too far behind in experience to really follow up or look to properly disengage. Predators free tanking the Phoenix shots now. No concerns in the world as Rapio looks to try and seize his mid-Phoenix by himself. And Rival will make pretty quick work of that left-hand Phoenix. And Meownate dashing forward, in fact, into Rapio, looking to challenge the Robin head-on.
Well, looks like that trade did work for him, but now is it going to continue to as the stun land? Geb shield one more time is right there, comes out perfectly to try and keep him standing. Predators has that Thorns a-ticking as mid-Phoenix is the only one that's still standing here at this point. They force everyone back, but Meownate wants a little bit more. He's up on the tree looking for a knockup and instead just falls back.
Mid-Phoenix going to end up falling in similar fashion to the left side. Now Rival still looking to maybe aggress even further. Fly, I believe he canceled his Tycho drums pretty early on there. It looked like maybe he thought that Retribution were going to choose to reinitiate, and then when he saw that they were actually backing off, he just doesn't even bother staying inside of that Tycho drums and just backs off entirely with the rest of his team. Rival just collected so much gold in that last siege. It may as well spend it all up, get that fourth item Transcendence online and the other items to suit.
How does 14,000 gold out in the lead sound to you, Taco? Would you take that? Does that sound?
It sounds like a fourth item Transcendence.
He's got it. Three stacks and a stacking, man. Rapio ain't even worried about it. You know, he's got some more cooldown to help out. There's no other cooldown in there. You know, I like it. As Vaporous Coast going to force USB, not even going to make it up into the air. Going to taunt, tanking the shots from Lizer as well. Vaporous Coast is too far out in front.
Oh,
Kraken gets Aegis out, so Vaporous still alive. Lizer wants a trade, but not going to be enough.
Vaporous now looking to press forward. Total Bad Boy could end up getting caught out of position here because he went to go save the life of his teammates. Vaporous with that Blood Forge. One more hit's going to give him that shield and the passive, and the taunts are non-stop. retribution. They know what they were getting into dealing with Team Rival in this set, and yeah, it's just part of the game.
It wouldn't be Vaporous Coast on the sticks, though, if he wasn't taunting. That's how we know it's him, right? That's how we know for sure it's my man still getting the big plays coming out in favor. As he finds the nice kill on the USB, even stands and tanks the shot from Lizer and still manages to survive through the Kraken. And now Meownate might be in trouble. He ashed through the Cosmos, might have to channel that one defensively, but they don't force it out just yet. Fire Giant has respawned.
This poor Gav Finch. I don't even know if Total Bad Boy is going to be permitted to hit level 12. And
you're
get
right.
That second relic. 20 minutes deep and Rival have just drained Retribution of every little bit of experience on the map. And there's just been limited opportunities for this team to safely farm.
Fire Giant should be there without really any trouble. No one from Retribution is even nearby. In fact, Predator's keeping Meownate from even farming the wave safely at this point.
Also, all jokes aside, on that Rapio 4th Item Transcendence build, it does give him a pretty nice power spike and the 10% cooldown reduction. He wasn't prioritizing cooldown early on, went straight for the damage and the burst because that's all he was really looking for on the Robin for good reason. Paired alongside a Fly, this duo has just done a fantastic job at stretching the pressure across the map as far as possible.
And a shout out to Dinosaur. I meant it when I said everyone was on their comfort picks, including Dinosaur on this Terra. And if you haven't seen some of these walls and where he's been positioning them so far, then you haven't been noticing what's been a lot of the facilitating factor here from Rival. He's been playing out of his mind as well, getting Earth and Furies on everyone and just tanking up everything.
And that's not always easy to do on the sticks either. That placement can get really finicky as well from controller in comparison to mouse and keyboard. So if that doesn't tell you guys how confident Overpowered you is, or excuse me, Dinosaur is on this Terra pick, I don't know what will. And speaking of what Overpowered, the Thanatos has not been able to accomplish that little bit of early game pressure.
Virtually
I think that
nothing.
That was where Retribution were expecting to have their compensation for weaker side lanes early on, but it was just way too much pressure poured onto Overpowered here with the Thanatos. He cannot do it alone into the draft that Rival went for.
Well, Meownate is up in the air as Rival have dived underneath the Phoenix. Does land a three-man knock-up, and USB is right here to follow up. No one in execute threshold yet, but he will land the stun on the Dinosaur. But it's Rapio who gets first blood, at least in this fight. Lizer gets chunked by the boulder. USB is incredibly low. Doesn't have the scythe available for the heal, and Rapio finds the double kill. Predators keeps Dobson pinned down, and Lizer barely able to make it back to the fountain.
Lizer barely able to stay alive, but the same can't be said for that right-hand Phoenix. His Rival already making quick work of that one. Mid and left sure to fall in similar fashion now. Lizer will extend that Darkest Nights, but it won't help him out all that much. In fact, he might even make it back to the fountain. No, he won't make it back to the fountain because Rapio's overhead kick is going to be enough to take him out.
Meownate gets caught as well by that Thunder Crash, so he's not going to be able to make it out. Dobson, a total bad boy, as bad as he is, not going to be able to get this one done. Left and mid-Phoenix have both fallen to the pressure from the minions. Titan, below half HP, Rapio wants to make sure he's godlike before the game ends. Rival takes game two and the set over Retribution.
Poor Geb, man.
It's a
level
rough life.
20 Robin collapsing on you, and you're just hitting level 12. I think he just got that secondary relic online.
Rough
that
life.
Was just Rival. That's the Rival that you expect to see time and time again, just complete and total domination.
And for what it's worth, I genuinely believe that is their dream draft. I think those are the five picks that they want more than any other picks. Those are their five individual preferred gods, and they played like it here in this game. I mean, they had pressure from minute one. Really, Retribution never looked in it. It's going to be tough for y'all out there in Mixer Chat to pick an MVP.
I think what I want to see from Retribution in the following weeks is for them to look for more styles compared to like that game one draft. I actually liked what they had in game one. They just didn't really look to abuse their pressure enough. I think that you could still keep a lot of those components from that original composition. They just changed it too much in game two. They went a little bit too off the wall there, and that just made it a little bit more easy, clear cut for Rival, I think, to kind of close that one out.
Yeah, Rival ended up coming out just looking a little bit too strong, I feel like, on that one for him. They had too much pressure early on, and Rival looking like very strong contenders to be one of the console representatives here once we start making our way towards Worlds and just to HRX in general. Again, y'all don't have to go through this gauntlet that the players do. You can just pick your tickets up at any time. And then when you're done with the main event, I think afterwards you're going to be wanting to go to that after party there, Taco. That's when really everyone's having a real good time. Might see Nox there. You know, maybe someone cosplaying November 18th. $50 will get you in the door. And remember, these tickets are not always available. It's a small window. So make sure you grab them when they're there.
And this is going to be where the stuff after the stuff really starts to take place, guys.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to want to make sure that you're there because it gives you a whole new insight to the community that you might not have been expecting, but bound to be a really fun time.
It really is cool, though. I mean, like some of your favorite players, personalities, you're just kind of sitting around sometimes.
You'll be there dabbing.
That's right. I'll be there dabbing. Yeah, very true sentence, apparently. You know, you can just, you know, just play some games. Everyone's around, very approachable. It's just so much fun with everybody hanging out. But back into the masterpiece that Rompio put together here in game two up against Retribution. I mean, this Robin pick, more so than anyone else, I feel like Rompio is just so synonymous with this Robin. When he gets it, it's so hard to slow them down.
I almost feel like he was toying with overpowered there. He could have autoed him for the kill.
He's like,
"No, I'm gonna beat you instead." Like just straight.
I want to fix that face.
Apparently,
that's what Robin says he's gonna do, and Rompio, true RP, wants to do that.
Well, Rompio not only fixing their faces, but also fixing the standings there for rivals.
Oh, yeah.
They're gonna go ahead and start moving their way upwards and stay at the very tip top.
The only undefeated team, I believe, now, right? After defeating Retribution. I think Retribution were 1-0 coming into that one. Not 100% sure. I'm pretty sure that's where Retribution were. Standings coming up. There we go. No longer do I have to guess. So, yeah, they're the only undefeated team. Taco, I was correct. Never questioned me ever again, by the way.
I wasn't saying anything, Finch. I let you take that one because, you know what? I wasn't 100% certain either.
That's true. Taco didn't question me. I don't know.
I whispered it because I wanted, you know. It gives the idea that maybe you couldn't hear me.
They heard you. I like what you're going for there, Taco. But either way, Rival just continue to look dominant. Every time we get to watch this team, they look stronger and stronger as a unit individually as well. I love following them. Hopefully get to see more form on Retribution. Got to tighten it up a little bit, I think, with those early game drafts and push the issue just a little bit more. But again, we'll get to see more from them later on. We got a little bit more Xbox action coming from you from the NA side. We're going to take a quick break, get everything ready for you, and we'll be right back.